we are seeing that more and more organizations want to baseline security. They want to take a risk-driven approach to security. They're going to their board and talking about the security metrics. What are some of the things that you think we should consider when we are taking these measurements on security? What are some of the success measures from a cybersecurity program point of view?
Well, I mean, I think, network awareness of what you have, what adversaries you're expecting, how many vulnerabilities you, patch, kind of the standard sort of table stakes that we all think about what we're doing. That's, the building blocks to having a security program. Are you vulnerability scanning? Do you have a threat analytics platform? Are you doing some sort of email gateway? I mean, what else?
Right. Yeah. I mean, you mentioned that having a good asset inventory is really important. Security awareness programs, like you'd mentioned, I think they're really helpful, especially with phishing attacks, which is pretty much the front door for probably most malware in companies comes through phishing attacks. So having really good awareness in there. I thought it was interesting you mentioned third-party vendors. And understanding their security practices. I would say most of us are pretty good about understanding our organization, what our assets are, what we need to protect. But when we're letting external parties access those assets too inside our company, we might not have as good visibility into these third parties and what these devices are, whether they're infected and compromised, who those actors, who those people are. You kind of give them privileged access to your networks. And you kind of trusting that they're doing their due diligence and good security practices, which may or may not be the case. So you could be letting, kind of a little bad action coming in through the side from a vendor.
It's
sometimes.
Kind of
so
the gray area with insider threat. Do you categorize that as an insider? You're kind of giving them privilege, but they're not really probably who you really think of when you're thinking of your first set of insiders, right?
Right.
Yeah,
right.
And when you think about the supply chain in terms of the different tiers of vendors that you have, you don't give everybody the same level of access. So I think it's important to think about a risk profile for all your vendors as well. So not only do you do risk management in-house, are you having sort of a risk rating or a grading measure for each of your vendors that you're letting into your network? Because today, the way security works and any business operations work, you just don't have like a well-defined perimeter and you cannot say everything is inside this. It's all the porous connections that you're making to this external part partners and other providers. So it's important that while you are measuring your risk profile and you're sharing threat intelligence maybe within the community, you're also keeping in mind that there is a tier of vendors that you're letting in and a risk rating is necessary for them as well.
Right.